We're gonna get started. Good morning, everybody. All right, let me get Miley out of here. Hang on. Miley, gotta go bye-bye. There we go. All right. Get this up here real quick. Boom. Okay. So, good morning, everybody. Happy Monday. I hope and trust everybody had a great weekend as we move towards July 4th. Crazy, right? July. Unbelievable. Okay, half the year is over. And now the focus is, of course, third quarter and fourth quarter, you know, as you all take your journey in whatever company you have chosen. So just so everybody knows, and I know this is redundant, but we conduct Success Zone every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. It's an open forum. No recruiting zone. So, you know, don't take people's names and try to recruit them into your company. Right? That's what rookies do. So what we do is just respect everybody and the decision they've made, because at the end of the day, right, we all do the same thing. And the focus for today's call is really leadership. And, you know, I know a lot of people on this call, you may be in a position in your company, you're just trying to figure out how to sell a product, right? And that's okay. That's your journey. Eventually, you're going to have to take on the face of leadership if you want to really believe you can achieve $1 million a year. No one's going to make $1 million a year, and you could write this down, by just you selling product. The beautiful part about this industry is that you get a percentage off other people selling the product. I know some people have been on my opportunity calls, and I always talk about residual income. And there's only two ways to earn it. One way is off your money or your investments. The other way is to get a percentage off other people's action. Well, we've chosen, all of us, a way to build a team so we could earn a percentage off other people's actions. And the action is to move to get your product or service into the hands of others through multiple levels of people that are doing that. You see how simple this really is to explain? I mean, if you talk to the average person and just said, listen, would you rather earn 100% off your efforts, or would you rather earn a percentage off other people's efforts? What do you think people would say? Well, why is it most people will go through their entire life only earning off their efforts? Here's why. They never ever commit to learn the skill set to get other people to follow them. That's leadership. And I've said this many times, are leaders born or are leaders made? And we could have that argument all day long, all of us. I believe leaders are made. When someone makes a decision to become, now they're just on a journey, right, to perfect that skill set. And over the last 25 years, I've learned you just got to get really good at telling people what to do. That's it. Listen, if you're dealing with the job mentality person understands being told what to do, right? We've been raised since we could 6 months, 3 months old, right? Our parents telling us what to do. Many times we didn't do it. I know I didn't do it as a rebellious teenager, but I was being told every day to do something. Then I got a job. I was told what to do. So when you get over here, the average person just wants to be told what to do. Well, see, that's where you take on the face of leadership. So you got to become not just an MLM leader, just a leader in general. It is someone who creates leaders, not followers. Okay? But see, here's the thing you're going to have to understand. Most people will only want to go as far as being a follower. They don't want to commit. Now you understand when I say, if you're going to make $1 million a year, that's not going to come from the masses. It's going to come from a handful of people that commit to being leaders. That's really all it is. But here's the problem. Can I tell you the problem? You can't pick a leader off a tree. I wish, oh, here's a leader. I'll grab this one. Well, here's one. You have one. Here's one for you. No, no. Leader is developed. Okay. It was 5 years into this where I start to really understand leadership. Before, I was just trying to figure out what, if I even wanted to do it. And there's always another level of leadership, always. In MLM, leaders sustain your business, not followers. That's what I just talked about. Because if you're going to put together an army of people, do you think you're managing the army? No, you're managing the generals, right? The generals manage the masses. And each general or leader, right, can have 50,000 people in their organization. It's building an organization of layers of leadership. And like I said, I know this may be completely over some of your heads, but eventually you got to place it somewhere and go, I know eventually what I got to get to. And that's what I want you guys to get good at. Okay. Identifying leaders. And when you see next time I do the attributes to success, that's what you're trying to identify. You're trying to go out there and identify people that have desire, right? That are willing to do whatever it takes, that are teachable, that are self-reliant. This is what I keep saying. We are professional investigators. But as you all know, the average new person will take anybody, and that's okay. That's part of their learning curve. But eventually you'll be able to identify a leader. You want to know why? Because you are. You're a leader. Okay, and that's the key to the business. So have a powerful vision. Successful leadership training has the capacity to translate vision into reality. Okay, now, powerful vision. You have to have your why. That becomes your vision. Why are you doing what you're doing every day? Why are you on these calls? Why do you go to your company's conventions? Why? What is that reason? And once you understand the why, that then powers your vision. The why powers the vision. And I'm telling you, the more belief you have, the bigger your vision. It's just what it is. My belief when I first got involved was, wow, I hope this works. And then it started to expand as I started to understand what I was really involved with. See, they have the capacity to translate vision into reality. See, vision for most people is a pipe dream. Right? Oh, I dream. How many people dream? We all dream. I wish. I dream. I hope. No, 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 no. A leader doesn't buy into that. They know they've chosen the right vehicle to get them to where they want to go. And that's leadership. Number two, product knowledge. Fact, product knowledge has nothing to do with performance. And also teach this to your team. If your team is solely focused in product knowledge, it's never going to grow the way you want. The product is the vehicle. And if you believe in your product, there's not much more to ever learn about it. I believe in it. And if I believe in it and I know my product sells because I've sold some, and I know my product works because I'm a user of it, what more do I have to spend on the product? See, your company that you're with right now is in the product business. You're not. You guys, you got to get this out of your head. You're not in the product business. You're in the people business. The people is the product. That's it. And here's the only reason I don't want you to misunderstand what I'm saying. How can your company put out a product that they think doesn't work? Can you imagine? Let's build a $1 billion company, but I'm not sure the product. That research has been done. That ship has sailed. Every company has a product story. Just leverage the story that's already been written. You don't have to be a product expert. But you want to be able, this is what you want to do. You want to get people out of the product business. And this is when you start to identify leaders, the ones that get this. And like I said, some of you may have, here's your organization. It's just you. Okay. Well, you got to buy into this first before you can get anybody else to buy into it. And this is why you have ongoing trainings. It's giving people the training as they want to hear it, or I should say as they're able to hear it. When I first saw a leadership training, it didn't resonate with me. But because they repeated the same trainings over and over, when I was ready, right? When the student is ready, the teacher will appear. When the student is ready, the training will appear. And some of you are ready to hear this. Some of you are still trying to figure out how to sell your product. That's okay. Okay? And I want you, because I have some people here that are aspiring leaders. They're leading a team now. And I know that. And I want you to become a great leader. Now, number three tip, dedication to your daily routine. Have we not beat this up, right, over the course of the last month? Create a similar routine for your team. See, when you put together your schedule, in the beginning, I knew what a spare time, part-time person did. Why? Because I was once a spare time, part-time person. And then as I went into more part-time and almost full-time, I knew what that meant. And I now know what full-time means. And now, you know what I really know? I know what all the time means. There's no schedule here as a leader. 24/7, people go, that sounds awful. No, how can you turn something off that you're passionate about? You know why people turn their job off? They're not passionate. Why do you think people, they dread Sunday night? Because they're not passionate about Monday morning. I get it. I understand that. But see, when you take this journey, when you start taking this journey and someone goes, hey, man, hey, Larry, I could give you 4 hours a week. Larry knows what to create for that person that wants to do it 4 hours a week. Because they're looking to Larry. They don't have the knowledge. They're looking to you. What does that mean? When we say to people, listen, does it matter? You could start this spare time part-time. And we all say that and we wave that flag, but do you know what it means? When the person says yes to you, can you show them what to do 4 hours a week? That's a leader. You know what I want someone to do when they first get involved? Not think. I just said, listen, here's what I want you to do. Remember, tell people what to do, see if they do it. Here's what I want them to do. I want them to take this company video that you all have. Everybody has a company video. And I want you to get this into the hands of as many people as you can. And here's the script I want you to use. That's it. Why? I want to see if he does it. And if he does, check. This could be somebody I could work with. But if that person starts calling you back up and saying, well, I don't know, I have to know more about the product before I could send this video out, I have to really understand the compensation plan. No, 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 dude. You didn't hear my direction. I didn't say you need to learn the product and the compensation plan. I said simply send out this information. If you get those types of questions, I will be there to support you with a three-way call. And I'm just watching what he does. But I've got to be able to create that routine for my person. If a person comes into your organization and says, listen, I've burned the boat. I want to know what to do on a full-time basis. Can you show them? Can you lead that person to someone that can show them? You see the breakdown in the industry? Normally, it's the blind leading the blind. Larry goes, hey, man, I'm blind. I want to sponsor you. Okay, what do you want me to do, Larry? I don't know. I'm blind. You see what starts to happen? It's the fact. But if Larry's blind, be smart enough, Larry, to lead him to someone that can see. So let's say I'm above Larry. Larry goes, well, listen, I can't see, but I know Jeff can. So even though I'm your sponsor, I'm going to get out of the way and I'm going to let Jeff lead you. Why? Because why would Larry lead somebody and he doesn't know what the hell he's doing? That's all. It's not a bad thing. Jeff has to get Larry to see. Well, if I bring in Larry and then 2 days later, Larry brings in Matt and Matt brings in Mike, you got three blind people in between. You follow me? So you got to be, as a leader, smart enough to know, because you can have a blind person be a really good recruiter. What if Larry's just a good old boy and everybody loves him? And every time he sends out a video, they say, I'm in. He's still blind. You guys got it? So get out of the way and let the person who has some vision lead your people. This is a big problem in our industry. Well, no, I'll lead my people. You don't know what you're doing, Larry. And I'll have that conversation. But as Larry leads his people to me, he'll start to see. Why? Because he's going to be part of everything I do. He'll be on the three-way calls. He'll be on my trainings. And eventually Larry's going to go, hey, man, I don't need this. I don't need this cane anymore. I don't need this C&I dog anymore. I'm good, Jeff. Great. That's leadership. That could be 6 months down the road. It could be a year. But I'm a leader. I've identified that. Some people get a recruiter and they go, this guy's good. And they just turn their back to that whole organization, but it's the blind leading the blind. You follow me? Be smart. Look at your flock, guys. And this is how you do it, but you got to be able to create the routine. Small changes that will make an impact. Small changes. People are getting involved with you because you're what? You're leading them to change. Biggest fear for a person is change. So small changes. What do you think I said? Just send out this video. That's it. Small. Don't worry about this. I got you here. I'm the one filling in all the gaps. And as I develop leadership, I start releasing my support. Because he says to me, I got this. Big part is time management, guys. You got to be able to show people what you want them to do. Okay. And that's going to help your business. That's for sure. Okay. Next. Oops. Okay. Learning is a never ending activity. Keep educating yourself. Right. This is committing to a daily routine, right? Oh, I missed. I really skipped. Hang on. How did that happen? Okay. Wow. Okay. Okay. Now, next, how to. Okay. Effective step-by-step training manual. Everybody has different trainings that your company provides. Okay. We do it here on Success Zone. It's an open forum for people that want to plug into it. And as you know, if you get people plugged into a system of education, right? It's going to help them. Now, here's the only way education helps you is if you take in the information that you receive and go out there and do. It's not just getting the information. Now you're just a very, very well-versed, right, person who's broke, right? I get it all. I've heard these trainings, but you're still broke. That's because you never went out there and exercised what you've learned. MLM leader tip 5, focus on motivating and training people that will greatly contribute to success. Disregard unproductive teammates. See, as you start to grow your group, you're going to be identifying. You're going to be identifying who to spend your time with. Now, when this says disregard unproductive teammates, okay, it doesn't mean you turn your back on them. They still may be on your auto ship. That's a productive person. Just know that. Don't try to tell yourself the person just on the auto ship who's never sponsored anybody is going to be a leader for you. That's just delusional. You follow me? Just know, okay, Larry's on that auto ship every month, $150. That's awesome. Larry's on my calls. When I see Larry, I still give him a big hug. I still high five him, but I know this is not somebody that's going to get my time. The only time I'm going to give Larry is when he sees me on one of these calls. Do you guys get it? That's not being mean. That's just business. A good MLM leader can handle disappointments and overcome failures. And more importantly, produce solutions. It's not whether or not you're going to have problems. Okay, that's forget all that. It's a matter of how many you're going to have and how you handle the problems. Because the very essence of this business is people enter into your business because they have a problem. And our job is to help them solve it. So people go, oh my God, I just got an organization full of problems. Good. You're supposed to help them solve it. Produce solutions. Now, you know how you produce the solutions? Probably because you've taken the same journey they're going to take. You see how you can't shortcut this, everybody? There's no shortcutting it. The reason I'm a good trainer is because I've been through the hell. Nothing you guys could present to me could shock me or Lisa. It's an impossibility. And that's why I say, hey, man, I understand where you are, because I do. See, I want you guys to be able to say that. I understand where you are because you've taken the journey. And the only way to do that is to stay in the game, to take the journey. I keep saying the same thing. You can't shortcut that. It's amazing what happens and what you learn. Every day you learn. Every day. Number 6, commit to prospecting numbers. Okay, leaders, they always commit to their number. Let me scratch that. They know their numbers. They know their numbers. Here we go again. That's part of taking the journey. They know how many touches to get a response. They know how many responses to get a closure. They know how many closures to get a leader. They know their numbers. Do you think a touch equals closure? No, a touch equals what? A touch equals a person that's going to receive your information. And then the numbers of people who receive your information, how many take the next step? And then how many people who take the next step, which is really probably a presentation, actually make a decision? And then how many people who make a decision actually turn into a leader? Whoa. That's why I say all the time, you don't need a lot of people. Because if you did, you could never make this work. But you need a lot of people to find the leader. Remember, what you can measure, you could always improve. If I'm working with a brand new person, and the person says, Jeff, this is not working, and we're 30 days in, I simply go right back and go, okay, so-and-so, show me how many people you touched in 30 days. First of all, show me your initial list. And then from that initial list, show me how many people got the present. See, I have to reverse engineer so I can identify the problem. I'll say, okay, here's the problem. You're talking to enough people, but they're not watching your video. So what does that tell me as a leader? He's probably not setting that up right. He probably hasn't set up the video. He probably just blind sent all these different videos. So I'm going to sit down with him and go, listen, let's try this. Before you send it, let's make the phone call and set it up that you are sending the video and they want to watch it. So I could find out the real issue they have to work on if they're doing the work. If the person says, well, Jeff, I've talked to three people. Okay, what's the problem? Well, you haven't talked to enough. So you could always measure. What you can measure could always improve. You got to have somebody that wants to measure themselves. Not afraid of the work. Number seven, it's not about what works. It's what duplicates. Jeff, I got this new program. Man, it's working for me. Well, Larry, explain it to me. And it's nothing the company teaches, but it's working for Larry. I'll give you a perfect example of that. Okay, when we got involved and we found a little niche, it was radio. And we then started to make a lot of money because we had all these leads coming in. And then we opened up our campaign to a group. And some people got involved in radio. You know who got involved in radio? The ones that could financially afford it. So if I was eliminating the people that couldn't afford it, was that duplicatable? No, it wasn't duplicatable. It was great for the people that could afford it. Now, we made a lot of money doing it, but it never grew to where we needed to grow. So just remember, your company has produced something they believe duplicates. Now, does that mean there's no you can't be open to other ideas? Of course not. But just make sure before you teach something, it's duplicatable. Number one, it's duplicatable. Because if it's not, okay, then it's not going to be a good fit. Transfer skills equals duplicate success. And really, right now, the big thing in the industry, see, it used to be what? It used to be CDs. It used to be cassette tapes. Then it went to CDs. Now everything's online. Right? Instant. It's getting faster and faster. So just make sure, and here's my best advice for most people on this call. Just follow your company's what they have, because they wouldn't teach it if it didn't work. Number eight, avoid asking for favors. Remember, this is leadership. Instead, give favors and add value to others and form meaningful relationships. Okay, what I mean by that, a leader takes control. A leader is self-reliant. A leader gives and gives and gives. And they form that relationship with their key people. Because I want loyalty. And the only way you give loyalty is you don't ask for it, you show it. You show it by becoming a good leader, a servant leader. To as many people as you can. Okay, you got to be able to give, guys. Okay, in the beginning, okay, it's okay to ask for favors. Remember, Larry's blind. Remember, he couldn't see. He needs me. I got to fill that gap for Larry. But I'm the leader that's going to fill the gap. Some people go, I'll fill the gap, and they never fill it, and that's how a line dies. The whole leg of business, Larry goes, I brought 14 people in and no one stuck. Well, that's probably because, right, you didn't pull in someone that could see. That's all. In the beginning, yeah, it's okay about asking for favors. The leader has to realize who that person is in their organization. Do not lead with your product. People become loyal to people. To values, to a community, and to leadership. Now, I'm not going to spend a lot of time here again because you guys know I've waved this flag for a lot, and sometimes I get a lot of pushback. You got to know your product. You don't understand people. Products come and go. Great products come and go on a daily basis. Do you think the product that you're marketing is the only product on the market? You may say, well, mine's the best. Well, the other person who has the other product believes theirs is the best. Why did I think Bally's was the best? Bally Health Clubs. Why do you think that? Anybody? Because they paid me. Period. I was loyal to Bally's because that's where the paycheck was coming from. Can I be honest with you? If 24 hours would have doubled my salary, 24 hour fitness, I would have been wearing the 24 hour fitness shirt. Sound familiar? Look at professional athletes when their contract is up. They've proven. They go, wait a minute. I've scored 24 points a game for 4 years. There's a value to that. My contract is up. Here's what I believe I'm worth. And that team says, you know what? I don't believe you're worth that. So that person goes as a free agent and says, and he starts to shop what he's done. And someone's going to put a value on that. Do you know what happens when you become a person who's proven to be a leader? You determine what you're worth now. You guys got it? But here's where it comes from. It comes from people becoming loyal to people, to values, to community, and to the leadership. There's a value to that. Remember what I said earlier? Leaders don't grow on trees. Well, if you become this leader, guess what? You could go anywhere. It doesn't matter the product. You understand the people business. I'm going to say it again because some of you misinterpret what I say. Does the product have to work? Of course. Does there have to be somewhat of uniqueness to it? Of course. But that's not my business. That's not my business. Apple, right, is a great product, but it's not the only game in town. So understand, okay, the real business you're in is the people business. Ask questions from the leaders you look up to, but respect their time and their expertise. Right? You always look in your genealogy. If you keep going up in your genealogy, there's a leader up there somewhere. If you want to get that leader's attention, do the right things. Make yourself known. I made myself known. I never missed a company event. Anytime there was a contest, I made sure I won and I got to that event. Otherwise, it made me nuts. I did volume. I wasn't a Siamese weasel, right? I wasn't someone always complaining and writing emails about this and that and what they liked and what they didn't like. Someone starts doing that to me, I have no time. I have no time for that. If someone wants my time, it's because they want to build a business. And I'm going to always respect my leader's time and their expertise. But it's not just because I asked for help. I earned it because I became a top recruiter. Maybe I won that contest, whatever it was. And then this is where you'll get, some of you are demanding it day one. You haven't done anything yet. Right? You have to show. You got to give to get. So it goes both ways. Okay, but don't be the person always complaining. Now, keep educating yourself. Learning is a never-ending activity. Always have a set time for learning every day. Remember the nine critical successes, right? Nine critical activities. Commit, this is part of it, guys. If you're on this, that's a commitment to want more information. But listen, your company has unbelievable leaders. Your company has unbelievable trainings. Just take advantage of it. I'm going to say this again, and I'm not senile. I know I repeat myself. Just don't be a professional learner. You could tell her, I'm working my butt off. I was on that success zone. No, that's not working. That's educating, and then for you to go out there and do. Best education is to go get beat up That is the best education. Okay. Number 12, do not pitch another MLM to your team. Even if it's just an online marketing tool, the weaker distributors will likely go where it seems to be the easiest and most likely will fail there as well because of their comfort seeking. Now, this could step on a lot of people's toes, but let me just tell you my opinion of it. Okay, my opinion is, and I'm going to contradict myself here, but you guys know my brain. I'm going to try to explain it. I believe if you're going to make $1 million, you can't chase two rabbits. Can't chase two rabbits. Can't build two multi-level marketing companies and become wildly successful. That's my opinion. Now, the other side of me is, if someone wants to be involved in four or five, okay, that's okay. I don't mind. That's your journey. But if you're going to ask me for my advice, I'd say pick one and go to work. But I'm not going to tell you what you can and cannot do. Okay, I would just tell you, if you're in my company, I just don't want you in a competing company. But if I'm in telehealth, right, which is what I'm in, and someone in my organization is in supplements, that has nothing to do with what I'm doing. Do you follow me? I don't care what they do, what they use. That's just weird. I don't care about that. But if that person says, listen, my telehealth business isn't really working and my nutritional supplement business really isn't working, then I would give the advice. Can I give you my advice? Pick one. And I'm not even saying to pick mine. Pick the one that you're going to spend the most time with. But some people, right, they go out there and they're trying to build seven at the same time. I'm telling you, I've never, and I've been in the industry a long time, ever seen anybody make that work. Can you imagine a top earner in another company doing three or four? They don't. Now, can you have multiple streams of income coming from three or four? Yeah. Maybe a couple hundred hours a month. So all I'm saying is this. If I'm a leader in my company, which I've always been, I never speak about any other company as a leader. Remember, there's few of those. The person at Amway is not talking about Shaklee. I promise you that. And I promise you, if you ever made over, I'll give you the magic number, $25,000 a month, you're not speaking about any other company. I promise you. The ones that do that don't make money in any of them. I'm talking about a significant amount of money. Okay? And they could tell you all they want. I got multiples for great. But I'm a leader. Here's what I'm doing. Leaders play their ball, and it's usually one, because that's where the money. If you're building a massive team, you don't have time. Are you kidding? To do that, but you guys could take that any way you want. In our company, we don't care how many companies you're involved with. Okay, that's up to you. But I also know in the back of my mind, that's probably not going to be my leader. Right? I know that, but that's okay. What if that person just uses my product or service? That's okay. Why would I throw that person away? Never. Never. I'm not stupid. Okay? So, just some advice. Number 13, get better. Okay, now we're really taking it to another level. Get better at presenting and speaking. Leaders lead. Leaders lead. Leaders have their own meetings. They have their own trainings. Why? Because they want the buck to stop here. You're going to have to do it. Biggest fear I ever had, I know it's hard to believe, was public speaking. Couldn't get me in front of the room. And if I did, I would be sweating like a warthog. I'd be sweating through my jackets. I'm talking about my suit jackets, sweating through them. Okay, but then eventually I go, man, you can't get me off the stage. Why? My belief. See, I didn't believe in the beginning. I didn't know what to say. When you're prepared, then, and your belief is there, you want to talk, you want that audience there every night. Here's a good book they recommend, How to Inspire Any Audience. Okay, let me tell you how to inspire an audience. Get results. If Larry went out there and he sponsored six people that week, I want him in front of my room. Larry wants to be in front of the room. I'm not going to ever put someone in front of my room that's not doing it. That's another problem. If you see people, right, and we're going to start to highlight people because my company we're with is in pre-launch. But as you start to see people stepping away from the pack, those are the ones that will be on our presentations. I want people that are doing it, leading my people, talking to my audience. Because the audience sees right through disbelief. Like people, you're always so excited. They call it rah-rah. If you consider excitement rah-rah, you better get some in your life. That's what I say. Okay, maybe you need a little excitement in your life. Okay, try it. It's called maybe smile once in a while. See, these are conversations I have. Because it does me no good not to make an impact. And sometimes that impact as a leader that and advice you give people hurts their feelings. That's okay. If it's coming from your heart and you know the advice you're giving them could help them, they may get mad at you. But then they're not willing to go the next level. But they may listen, get mad, and go back and think about it. You know how many times I got mad at the person that was leading me? Oh my gosh. And the words I would use to myself about that person, but I knew the heart was right. I knew. So get better at presenting. Start with one-on-ones, guys. Start knowing your presentations. Okay, some of you don't even know your company's slides. So how can I do a presentation? Can you sit down with somebody, let me ask you a question, and just go through the presentation? See, the day you do that and lead someone to closure, whew, that belief is unbelievable. Well, Jeff, I could see. You know, Jeff, it's Larry. I just went through the whole presentation deck. I played the video. I then gave him an alternate choice close, and he got involved with me. Do you know you'll never forget that day? Never forget that day. Larry did it. And now, Jeff, I could see. So I'm doing the three-way calls for my new person. I'm the one they're leading people to. You've arrived. You're taking responsibility for your business. But in the beginning, remember, Larry was the guy that couldn't see that was spare time, part-time. I told him to start sending out some videos. Now he's sitting down and doing his own presentations. Wow, duplication's happening. You got to be the first person, right? That's how you do this. When you experience a downturn, inevitable, by the way, you will notice that results are directly linked to the amount of exerted value and the number of people you contact about the business. Okay, now, let me tell you what this means. In the beginning, what's controlling your paycheck is your efforts. Because you don't have anybody. Right? When you sponsor somebody, now you have somebody. You sponsor two people, now you have you and two people. So it's an emotional roller coaster, good weeks, bad weeks, because you're pushing the snowball up the hill. Eventually, the lows don't get as low. And it starts to really even out. That's because you have a lot of people in your organization. So when we say downturn, normally it's because you've stopped doing the thing that brought you to the dance. And you know what that is? You all know what it is. It's sponsoring. It's the number one thing most people stop doing. Once they get a group they think is a group, That's another thing. They think they sponsored three. They have a group. Wait, what? Two-thirds do nothing. Well, what's two-thirds of three? One. So now you go, I'm stopped my recruiting. I got my group. Well, good luck with that. That's where people see a downturn. And then what if you have a group of 100? Right? But it's you haven't identified all the blind people. You release those 100. Let's say those 100 are sitting on top of five legs. Combined, you have 100 people. But let's say the five people are blind, which mostly they are. And the leader hasn't identified that. I go, I got my 100 people being led by the blind. Well, guess how fast that thing could unravel? Very quickly. See, you see, it's awareness. That's what this training needs you to do. Be aware. Be aware of where you are in this journey, and then be aware of what and identifying with people in your group. Although, then you won't have the ups and downs of the business. You're aware of it. Okay, I see this downturn. I see how I went from, I made $6,400 this month. Oh, and all of a sudden, next month I made what? Okay, I made $1,000. Well, why did that happen? Well, here I brought in 10 new people. Here I kept not sponsoring, and I was having my people led by the blind, and now I have nobody left. You know how many times I've seen companies, or I should say business legs, unravel? Just unravel, nothing was holding it together. So just be aware of this. And I'm just telling you, the biggest problem when you experience a downturn is no new people being added into the organization. Okay? 15, if you do something long enough, a ratio will appear. What you lack in skills, make up in numbers. If you want to learn fast, fail forward fast. Fail and learn and then get better. Jeff, what's my secret to success? Fail fast. That sounds horrible. That's the business. That's why I'm saying when you're failing, that's a success story. You got to turn it. You got to turn it. If you take every failure, I'm telling you, you'll have a 30, 60, 90 day cycle if you don't turn that failure into success. What do I mean? Okay. Larry's numbers today are 10. Let's say Larry got 10 no's and really bad no's. It wasn't just like, no, Larry, not for me. Good luck to you. They were bad no's. What are you doing, Larry? Are you kidding? I would never do multi-level. That's a scam. Can you imagine? I'm talking about 10 bad no's. Larry's brushing his teeth at night. He's looking in the mirror. You know what he's got to do after he rinses? Smile and go, hey, man, I did good today. I did good today. I had a successful day. Now, can I ask you all a question? Why? Because he failed. He did his numbers. I didn't say sponsor 10 people. I said, Larry, meet your numbers today. And he calls me up and goes, Jeff, I am so excited. Larry, why? What's up, brother? Jeff, let me tell you about my nose. Let me tell you about Stan. He was really mean to me. That's awesome, Larry. Let me tell you about Mary. Oh, my God, Mary. I thought Mary was a sweet Christian woman. She went to church every Sunday. She really laid into me. Oh, man, that's awesome, Larry. High five. Let's have a beer. Tell me about the other 7. We're having a beer now. You see, I'm turning into a pod. Now Larry feels good. Man, that was an awesome day. That's a success. You guys get it? Here's a bad day. Larry does nothing. Doesn't get a no. Doesn't get a yes. But he was on success zone. Bad day, Larry. Okay. Brush your teeth, right? Go to bed. Bad Larry. Okay, you see? That's how you turn it. Every time you get an answer, a yes, a no, anytime you touch a person, you're successful. You got to believe that. Just run your numbers. Fail fast. Constantly associate with other leaders. Guys, sometimes you got to fire your friends. Hate to tell you that. I don't want Larry hanging around those 10 people, right? From a business standpoint, that try to steal his dream. Why? Get around other leaders, Larry. People who think bigger than you. Set a higher standard. Have a high expectation. If the leader gets soft, his followers become very weak. I don't want weak people around me. I want to bring them up, but I got to create that circle. I always want to be around the heat. That was just me. Always, in anything I ever did. Even at Bally's, when I was a minimum wage employee, making $3.35 as a locker room attendant, I was always, always hanging around the manager's office. Always trying to listen. When they went out to eat or have a beer, I was always hanging out. Just wanted to be around it. Then I want to be around the supervisors. Then I want to be around the VPs. Well, same thing here. It's the same thing. It's the same organizational structure as corporate America. There's always somebody above you, right? But see, don't put yourself below. I'm going to be there. I'm just on my journey. And a leader will identify that because they see themselves in you. Because every leader's gone through this, guys. Every leader, no one shortcuts this. You can't. Can't shortcut it. Even if they did shortcut it, they wouldn't be in front of the room. I promise you. In other words, let's just say a leader got in because, and they're making $50,000 a month because they had some people underneath them that were really the leaders. That person you'll never really see. Because they can't wave that flag because they know they really did anything. You know why I'm so passionate? Because I know what we built. I know it was because of hard work. And most people would never go through what we've gone through. Very few. But that makes you special, right? Remember, there's a value to that. Avoid doing anything you don't want your team to duplicate. Okay? It's kind of redundant. Okay? Just remember, don't make sure no matter what. In other words, let me give you an example of this. Do you think I need the PowerPoint presentation to get somebody in the business? Do you think I need the company video? No. But do I always show the company video? Yes. Do I always do the PowerPoint presentation? Yes. Why? Because that's what I want people to duplicate. I don't need it. I don't even need a product. I get somebody in based on my vision. You follow me? But how duplicatable is that? So when Larry's watching Jeff, he goes, wow, do you see Jeff? He played the video. Jeff did the PowerPoint presentation. He read the slides. It's the other thing. I do the slide that people are looking at. I'm not doing the slide and I'm talking about something else. What is that saying? Larry's going, well, what's he doing? He's talking, but it's nothing to do with the slide. Duplication. So I'm always following whatever company, 5-step program, 7-step program, 10 steps, whatever you want me to do, I'm doing. I'm just exerting, or I should say, I am putting into that my experience. That's all. So just make sure you follow the systems. Number, what are we, 18? Be transparent to your team and never have a lack mentality. Let people know you struggled. Share with them what really works and duplicates, and you will see a positive result. Remember Larry? I'm talking to Larry. He's talking about the 10 people that beat the you-know-what out of him today. Larry, don't worry about that. Let me tell you about a person that really stole my dream. So I start telling war stories. So Larry's going, wow, wasn't just me, Jeff. No, Larry, really? Are you kidding? Take those 10 no's, okay, times them by 10,000, and you have my no's. That's why I'm successful, Larry. Wait, because you got 100,000 no's is why you're successful? Yes. Well, I better get busy getting my no's. Yes, Larry, now you're on the right path. Just don't become an alcoholic doing it. Because you're having a beer every time you hear a no. You'll be a Betty Ford. Ah, that was funny. All right. Number 19. Don't fall in love with technology. MLM is all about connecting and working with people. Processes don't do work, people do. Guys, listen. Technology is a great complement to our industry. No doubt. But I've seen companies that say, you know what? I never even see a person. I could sponsor all day long. I never even have to talk to them. Really? Good luck with duplication. Technology is a definite complement. There's no doubt. But don't ever think you could take the people part of this out of the MLM equation. Don't think you could take the people out of any equation. If you want to build, this is all about connecting. I may be able to recruit somebody because I have a series of webinars, but eventually that person has to see somebody. And if they see me now and I'm a leader, Larry goes, man, I just connected with the, I got in because I saw a bunch of videos, but I connected with this guy, Jeff. I really like him. Okay, and I'm going to be working with this. Now, do you think that solidifies Larry in the business? Sure it does. Connect, become a good people person. The processes don't do the work. People do. People get involved with people they believe, like, and trust. And they stay involved with people they believe, like, and trust. You don't have to like me. That's okay. That's okay. But I do know that you can't say, well, maybe you can. I don't believe you can say that I'm not going to give you the right advice, good or bad. Good or bad. I don't care if I step on some people's toes. That's leaders. Leaders don't always have to be liked, right? Remember, a leader doesn't care what other people think. A leader cares what he thinks. And he knows, because his heart is right, the advice he's given to people can aid in their success. That's what a leader believes. Number 20, live a great lifestyle that matches your MLM leader status. Okay, people believe what they see, guys. As you start making more, okay, show it. Show it. I'm not saying you have to wear Versace or Gucci. I'm just saying people... lifestyle is a big selling point here because they don't have it. That's probably a big reason they got involved. They want to change something in their life. And you're the one they're looking up to. So that's all we're saying here. So that's the training, guys, today. So I hope this maybe hit home with some of you. Let me do my share screen. Where's all my peoples? Oh, well. There's Steve. There's Sonia. I'm scrolling. There's Armand. There's Charlotte. Hi, guys. There's Christy. You having another summer day with the girls, Christy? There's always a field trip or something going on. A picnic. Hey, Jenny. All right, guys. Hope you had a great day. See you guys on Wednesday. Mwah. See ya. Stop recording.